Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event is set for one fall. Introducing first, weighing in at a combined weight of 517 pounds, Stunning Steve Austin and Brian Bryan.
Fans, I hope you'll join us this Saturday, 9:05 Saturday morning for the all-new Power Hour. I'm sure Tony and company will have information on Halloween Hammock. And we'll tell you about WCW Saturday night right after you hear this.
And Dylan Pulitz, weighing at a combined weight of 482 pounds, Shane Douglas and Ricky, the Dragon Steamboat.
As Steamboat and Douglas make their way to the ring, remember on WCW Saturday night, Eric Watts will go one-on-one with beautiful Bobby Eaton and Michael Hayes. I understand that Paulie Dangerously obviously upset that the Super Intruder couldn't get it done last night, has enlisted another one of his employees, shall we say, in beautiful Bobby Eaton.
Well, you know, he just made a mistake last week. He's been investing his money in the wrong places, but who am I to say? He signs my check, I spend my money well. But it'll all be taken care of this Saturday, and a lot of it will be taken care of tonight.
We'll also have a feature on the King of Cable coming to TBS at WCW Saturday night. We'll have a special feature on that this Saturday, 6:05, 2 hours here on TBS. It's Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Stunning Steve Austin.
I love to see these two guys wrestle. They had some of the most classic matches of all time for that TV title. You know, Jim, Steamboat might be a great husband, a great father, but he's not a good tag team partner because he can't keep one. He must be hard to get along with.
Well, I haven't heard that
look at all the partners
situation. I think he would be a great guy to be tag team partners with. He's been world tag team champions 4 or 5 times. Side headlock takeover by Stunning Steve Austin to the head scissor by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Steamboat up and Austin, for that matter, very, very quickly. Steamboat and flying Brian Pillman.
I thought I seen it, too, in the hair.
Well, I happen to miss it, but I'll keep a closer eye on it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, Steamboat doesn't have a long history of hair pulling.
There's always a time to start. Speaking of starting, we start at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 Central, and I hope all you idiots set your clocks back last night.
Good martial arts flow. What a chop! And what another by Steamboat. Steamboat nailed it, Stunning Steve Austin. Austin bailing out here.
Good
and
move.
Steamboat nails him on the apron, Mike.
Oh, man. See, you got to get out. He gets going like a fast-breaking basketball. You got to stop it, or he'll stop your career as far as winning.
Side headlock takeover. Got a couple of nice letters this week from some fans down in Augusta, Georgia that are going to be with us this Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. Big event in Augusta, Georgia.
My nephew's going to be there.
Home of the Masters. Does he call you Uncle Mike?
Yes, he does. It's going to be interesting to see when Pillman gets in the ring. Seems like they're trying to stay away from each other because of tonight.
Great double drop kick by Douglas. And Steamboat, oh, they elevate Pillman up in the lights. They knock down Stunning Steve Austin. Steamboat follows Austin right outside and says, oh, no, you don't. You're going back in there. And waiting is Shane Douglas. Irish slip bar side, lateral press. He's got the leg hook. Referee Randy Anderson a little late getting there, but he got two.
He had him there. I hate to admit it, but he won't get me or Bobby Arn like that tonight.
Tag made. Stunning Steve Austin. Should be making the exchange with Flying Brian. He made the tag, didn't he?
Well,
that's one way to get him in there. Here comes Steamboat. All four guys in there, and the referee having a little trouble keeping control here. And Pillman, he just...
Resourceful. Well,
he was very resourceful in bringing Shane Douglas to the top turnbuckle. Face first. Big knife-edge chop there.
Those will sting you. Believe me. Get him again.
Hear the impact of those chops. Irish whip. And Pillman gets caught coming off the second turnbuckle. Waistlock into an atomic drop, driving his spine and compressing the vertebra. Drop kick. Caught him outside. I hear the concrete.
Shane Douglas probably pulled one of the biggest upsets of his career yesterday on WCW Saturday Night when he defeated this man, Steve Austin. Of course, it was a tainted victory.
Pillman and Douglas certainly are developing an outstanding rivalry, but as far as Pillman's single career is concerned, he can certainly look back at tonight's matchup with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat as perhaps a turning point as far as him really being able to elevate himself to a superstar status.
It should catapult him.
Irish whip far side. And Douglas trying to go for the crucifix. He's got him down. He's got him in a pinning predicament, and he got two there.
He has really widened his repertoire since coming back to WCW, and I mean Shane Douglas.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, snap mare into the reverse chin lock. Fans, don't forget, if you can't watch Halloween Havoc on pay-per-view, Lance Russell and Gordon Solie will be covering it live for the Wrestling Hotline. Sting will be taking your calls beginning at 8 o'clock. They're going to have a lot of guests on there.
They better call him because you won't be able to talk to him after the match. I mean, he's through. He's finished.
Austin now forces Steamboat back on the ropes. Buries that shoulder deep in the midsection there.
Come on.
And one more time.
Yeah.
Fans, we've got to take a commercial break. As is traditional here on WCW, if a decision is rendered during the commercial break, we'll show it to you as soon as we come back. Don't go away. The main event continues in a moment. Steamboat with a chop on Pillman. And Pillman now that shot right to the abdomen. Welcome back, everyone, to TBS and the main event. Jim Ross and Michael Hayes back with the tag team action here. It's a great one. He's got both arms hooked there in a near fall.
Oh, good move.
Pillman and Steamboat have really hammered each other.
Get him out.
Commercial break. Pillman throws Steamboat outside. Austin there.
He's taunting him. Good psychology. Keeps the referee tied up. Get an extra lick or two in.
Austin now throws Steamboat back inside. What a matchup here on TBS in the main event. We're just over an hour away from the 8 p.m. Eastern Time start in Philadelphia. Big chop by Steamboat. And here comes Pillman right back. Again, as we mentioned, these two guys will go one-on-one live for the world to see at Halloween Havoc on pay-per-view tonight.
Next Friday on my hotline, I intend on having some comments from the manager of what's going to be the new world champion, the Barbarian, Cactus Jack.
A lot of things going on the hotline. As Austin with that right hand, it finds its mark on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. One more time, he buries that shoulder to the midsection.
I couldn't believe your predictions last night on your hotline.
I think this is going to be this was hard to call because of so many unknown variables. Great move there by Steamboat. Steamboat counters any way he can.
Yes, and he's got so many ways. That's the problem. You just don't know. You look left, he comes right.
Steamboat will team up next week with Nikita Koloff and Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
See?
Here on TBS.
Can't keep a partner.
He'll take on Cactus Jack, Tony Atlas, and the Barbarian. Plus, I'm sure we'll have some Halloween Havoc highlights here next Sunday as well. Lion Bryan scoops up Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, trying to put him away.
This is it.
Coming up on that second roll. And
Whoa!
Steamboat had that one well scouted. Obviously, he got the knees up. He drove them into the stomach of Lion Bryan Pillman. And Pillman now needs to make the tag. He's close to doing so. And he does get the tag. And Steamboat makes the tag to Shane Douglas. Shane Douglas now with a full head of steam and a lot of momentum. He nails Pillman. Douglas, a youngster from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, really cooking here on the main event.
He's got a lot more upper body strength than he used to. You got to take him out with the legs. That's the thing to do with him.
All four men have found their way back into the ring. Randy, don't call me Pee-wee Anderson, having trouble keeping this one under control.
Get him off, Pee-wee. Come on. Enforce the rules.
I think Douglas and Austin are the legal men in here, if I'm not mistaken. Pillman has threw Douglas outside. Douglas counters Pillman. This one is really getting a little chaotic. Steamboat coming back around to the corner where he can be there for the tag.
Where he's supposed to be. No wonder he can't keep a partner. He wanders around, and then this happens to his partners. I know who Rude's referee's going to be, but I ain't going to say, and you're going to be surprised.
One of the many questions that will be answered on pay-per-view at Halloween Havoc tonight. Austin, who made the tag with Pillman, just a big-time cheap shot on Steamboat, who is still hurting from his last tenure with Austin and Pillman in the squared circle. Austin, going up top.
Taking a little too much time, I think.
I think you're right, and Douglas able to push him off and counter it.
Cut him off. Don't let him tag. Good move.
Austin, following Michael Hayes' advice, bearing that shoulder, not allowing Shane Douglas to tag in Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
And as we look at this great tag team matchup, almost got him. I think we'll have new world champions tonight.
There's a tag. Here comes Flying Brian back in. Pillman and Austin have been a very impressive combination in the outings that I have seen them compete in. I think both of them have their sights set, however, on one-on-one matches primarily. But from time to time, we may see them in tag team competition, as we are here.
Look how smart Pillman is. He's keeping the legs away from him. Though Douglas is reaching, he can't secure that hold.
And Douglas makes a tag to Steamboat.
I don't think he did it.
I don't think the referee's going to allow it. He didn't see it.
Can't call what you can't see.
In the meantime, an illegal double team by Pillman and Austin. Austin with the help of Pillman, and now the ropes. The referee tripped right over him.
He's hustling.
He ought to saw his feet in the ropes. He fell over.
It's not easy refereeing a tag team match or any professional wrestling match for that matter.
Well, I'll agree with you on that.
You know that.
You're exactly right.
And two refs tonight.
Who will they be? Who will Chono select and who will Rude select? Fans will have a special program on AM 750 WSB tonight at 9. We taped it earlier. Got some very interesting interviews I think you'll enjoy. On AM 750 WSB at 9 tonight, wrestling with Jim Ross. And once again, Steamboat makes the tag. And once again, the referee was being diverted by Flying Brian. And again, they follow the exact same game plan, an illegal double team. And this one, it could be over now for Douglas. But thanks to Steamboat, he interrupts the count.
Here goes Steamboat's temper. He knew he made that tag. And he wasn't taking no for an answer.
Douglas and Austin squaring off, as are Steamboat and Pillman. Clothesline by Douglas. I think Doug, who's the legal man here? Douglas and Pillman, I think.
I think so, but all these moves are great, but if you don't cover somebody, you can't get a free count.
He threw him over the top. That's a disqualification.
He's waiting for tonight.
Douglas may be hurt here. A disqualification victory for those two.
Good.